Hello, my name's Dr. Harun Gadraj, Director of the Vein Care Centres in the southwest of England. One of the commonest questions I get asked, both by doctors and nurse colleagues, is what is a sclerosant and how exactly does it work? Sclerotherapy is the injection of a chemical pharmacological agent directly into the lumen of a vein, and this results in the permanent occlusion of the vessel and healing by fibrosis. So it achieves the same as a surgical removal, and the chemical injected into the vein is called a sclerosant. Sclerotherapy is really very versatile. It's the only single modality of treatment that can be used for nearly any vein in the superficial venous system of the leg. Sclerotherapy is the treatment of choice for thread veins, spider veins, and their feeder veins called reticular veins. And in addition, sclerotherapy can be used to treat varicose veins, reflux in the great saphenous vein and the small saphenous vein. It can treat residual veins, that's leftover veins after other treatments such as laser and venous closure. It can be used to treat recurrent veins, that's veins that come back after treatment, and it can be used to treat incompetent perforator veins. Sclerosing agents can be classified into one of three different types: detergents, osmotic agents, and chemical irritants. Now, very few people in the United Kingdom use osmotic agents such as hypertonic saline because they are painful on injection, and if the sclerosant leaks out of the vein, it can damage the skin quite severely. Very few people in the United Kingdom use chemical irritants such as chromated glycerine because they can cause serious allergic reactions and serious complications such as kidney failure. Most specialists in the United Kingdom use detergents such as sodium tetradecyl sulfate, fibrovane, or polidocanol, ethoxysclerol. This is how sclerosants work. They all cause endothelial destruction, and the aim is to cause endothelial destruction over a sufficient length and circumferentially so that when an inflammatory reaction is initiated, it leads to healing by fibrosis and complete obliteration of the vessel wall. Detergent agents work by disrupting the delicate cell membrane of the endothelial lining, and they are used in their liquid form to treat thread veins and reticular veins. One of the special characteristics of detergent sclerosants is that they can be mixed with air, and as a foam sclerosant, they can be used to treat large varicose veins or reflux in the great saphenous vein and the small saphenous vein. Now, as you can see from the right-hand side of this slide, in some cases there can be quite a lot of clot forming in the vein lumen, and occasionally this clot can organise and the vein can recanalise, leading to failure of the treatment. So it's very important after sclerotherapy to follow the patient up and, if necessary, perform more sclerotherapy to areas that are recovering. Well, that's what a sclerosant is, and that's how sclerotherapy works. I hope you found this video interesting and useful. Do please remember to subscribe, and that way you'll be amongst the first to hear about my next video. Thank you for watching.